Now, I don't know if many of you at home can remember way back in the 60s when there used to be a late-night Eamon Andrews chat show. Do you remember that? You probably do. Well, I appeared on that one night, and I coined a phrase. I happened to say that it took me 17 years to become an overnight success. And the reason I said it at the time was because, having been in show business for years and years and years at the time, I did an 8-minute spot on the famous Sunday night at the London Palladium, and it did, in fact, bring me overnight success. Now, at one stage of my career, I spent a long time singing with an Irish vocal group, and we used to sing lots of traditional songs, and we sang a lot of old stage Irish songs because we did work on the music hall here a lot. And on that Palladium show, I did one of those little Irish songs, and that little song changed my life. It really did. So if you'll bear with me just once more, I'd like to sing it for old time's sake. It goes like this. Now Delaney had a donkey. That everyone admired. Temporarily lazy and permanently tired. A leg at every corner, balance in his head. And a tail to let you know which end he wanted to be fed. Riley slyly said, we've underrated it. Why not train it? Then they took a rag. They rubbed it, scrubbed it, they oiled and imbricated it. Got it to the post and when they started, dropped the flag. There was Riley pushing it, shoving it, shushing it. Hogan, Logan and everyone in town. Lined up attacking it and shoving it and smacking it. They might as well have tried to push the town hall down. The donkey was eyeing them, openly defying them. Winking, blinking and twisting out of place. Riley reversing it, everybody cursing it. The day Delaney's donkey ran the half-mile race. The muscles of the mighty never known to flinch. They couldn't move the donkey a quarter of an inch. Delaney lay exhausted, hanging round his throat. With a grip just like a Scots on a £5 note. Starter Carter, he lined it with the rest of them. When it saw them, it was willing then. It raced up, ready for the best of them. They started off to cheer it, but it changed its mind again. And there was Riley pushing it, shoving it, shushing it. Hogan, Logan and Mary Ann McGrath. She started poking it and grabbing it and choking it. It kicked her in the bustle and it laughed, hee-ha. The Whigs and Conservatives, the radical superlatives, liberals and Tories, they hurried to the place. Stood there in unity, helping the community. The day Delaney's donkey ran the half-mile race. The crowd began to cheer it, and Rafferty, the judge, he came up to assist them, but still it wouldn't budge. The jockey who was riding it, little John McGee, was so thoroughly disgusted that he went and had his tea. Hagen, Fagan were students of psychology, swore they'd shift him with some dynamite. They bought it, brought it, and without apology, the donkey gave a sneeze and blew the whole lot out of sight. There was Riley pushing it, shoving it, shushing it. Hogan, Logan and all the bally crew. Police and auxiliary, the garrison artillery, the second in the skillings and the lifeguards too. They seized it and harried it, they picked it up and carried it, cheered it, steered it to the winning place. Then the bookmakers drew aside and they all committed suicide. The day Delaney's donkey won the half